Over the last 2 weeks, the dancehall space has been buzzing with this track. Different currency, money has become in currently. But what's really causing the buzz? Is it Skillibeng?
Is that
the subject or the chapa gyal? Right now, right here on our stage, we are about to demystify the chapa gyal, who goes by the name or the moniker Honey Milan. Right now, right here on our stage. Honey, welcome.
Hello, nice to meet you.
It's good to meet you too. So answer that for us. What is really causing this buzz?
The song.
So it's not who in it, not you, nor
well,
Skilly.
I really feel like it would have did good without him too.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, so whose song is it?
It's my song.
Okay.
And he's the feature. Well, I actually sent him a couple songs, and he said he would get on them, and then it so happened that I came up with Chapa Gyal. I was just like, you know, you should just get on that.
Yes. So, and you think it would have done well without him?
Yeah, maybe it would have took a little bit more time.
Yes.
But I think it still would have did good.
So his brand has brought the attention.
Yes.
Because he's got very big following.
Yes.
Okay, so, but you're confident that it would have made it on its own without him?
Yeah.
That's interesting. All right, let's see how involved to it right now. Me a the first girl chopper, me we chop for the whole night, it no matter. Me chop a girl, $1 million girl, heavy link, lock a bank, tell you, cash a stack. That's it. Chop a girl, and here she is. So, you're satisfied with the performance of the song so far?
Yeah, why not? I mean, it got taken down, but, you know, I'm satisfied with that people are recognizing my talent.
Okay. It got taken down. Explain that for us. What happened?
Well, I mean, the company basically sent us a cease letter saying that we need to take it down because, you know, they've been in business since 1972, and they don't want scamming associated with their brand.
Yes. What is the business?
A hardware business?
Don't want their brand to be associated with, because images of the brand.
It was just like 2 seconds, but you know.
2 seconds,
yeah.
Of the brand.
The whole building.
The building?
Yes.
Was displayed in the video?
Yeah.
So you pull it?
Yeah, we had to change it.
It changed.
And then take it down and then re-upload it on both channels.
How do you push back at the hardware, because they don't want to be associated with quote-unquote scamming?
Right. I mean, I really, at first I was like, I really don't see the big deal, but then I thought about it and, you know, I respect their decision, you know, it's their brand, so.
Yeah, but you are not involved in scamming, are you?
No. No.
And is that chopping, something you're supporting or promoting, are you?
Chopping is a lifestyle,
yeah.
You know? So it just doesn't have to do with scamming, you know? Like, you can be a mother and you go to work and chop it up and come home. You make sure chopping is a lifestyle. A lot of people, me personally, feel like not have what it takes to be a chopper girl, because a chopper girl, she have ambition, she's a go-getter, she's hardworking. So that's how I feel about that.
Mm-hmm. So the chopping is used for?
It's a lifestyle.
For hustling?
Yeah, it's a lifestyle, a go-getter, ambition, you know? It can be whatever you want to make it, whatever
okay.
You got going on in your life.
So why did they apply, in your view? Why
because
do you think
I'm a
they
female.
Went, they came after you?
Because I'm a female
scamming.
Artist, because guys do it all the time. Mm-hmm. And you never really hear nobody say nothing like that. It's because I'm a female. But I saw it go.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Any discrimination against you?
It's fine with me. People are gonna talk regardless about anything, so I'm just gonna keep doing what I'm doing.
Yeah? Anyway, your artistry is, my view is, you're an artist.
Yes.
And we hope that you will get a chance to really get to exhibit your talent more.
Yes.
But you probably should should start to condemn the action clearly to all that you're not a believer in scamming. So
yes.
A song is a song and nothing more than a song.
Yes, you know, I'm an entertainer. I do music. Music is art. Art is an imitation of life. Mm-hmm. And me, if it wasn't hot or something to talk about, I wouldn't even write about it or go on the booth and talk about it. So it's something that everybody knows about, everybody I talk about. So, you know, it's nothing personal.
Okay. All right. So who were you before this?
I've been doing music since I was 14 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been doing music my whole life. You know, there's nothing that I love more than music. I've always been doing music. I have songs that are out.
Yes. How established were you in music?
Very, but I was more doing writing, you know, writing for people.
Okay, for Jamaican artists or?
Both.
Both?
Yes, American and Jamaican.
Okay, so hip-hop,
R&B? Yes, hip-hop, reggae, dancehall, R&B, yeah. Mm-hmm.
But this is your biggest buzz in Jamaica?
Yes.
Okay, so let's talk about your accent, which suggests that you don't live in Jamaica.
Me a Jamaican.
Yes.
And I grew up in America, so I get the best of both worlds.
Yes.
And that's how it influences my music.
Okay, so you're also a what, hip-hop artist?
Well, yes, but you know, I want to focus right now on
dancehall.
You know, and when I drop the Chopper Girl mixtape, because I'm going to be dropping a Chopper Girl mixtape on the 9th of July, then, you know, everybody can get to know me, because everything about me is going to be on there.
Okay, well, see how much you can tell us now by going back to where in the U.S.?
Miami.
What community in Jamaica were you born?
I'm Ocho Rios, but my mom built her house in Monique, so we moved to Monique, yes.
And you went to the U.S. when? At what age?
Very young. Like, I went, like, around 7 and then back and forth, like say, 3 years. Mm-hmm. Like, I would go there, and then 3 years, I would go back, like, while my mom was situating herself and building her house. She didn't want to leave us with anybody, so she would always take us.
Mm-hmm. So you went to school in the U.S.?
Yes, and here.
So
both equally.
Equally?
Yeah.
So are you more Jamaican or more American?
More Jamaican.
And music was always what you were interested in from that time?
Yes.
As a baby, a child?
I was in a choir.
Yes.
And then, you know, I always do music. When I got my first laptop, I downloaded Audacity, and you know, I didn't have a mic at the time, so I used my uncle's Xbox headphone, and I was recording like that. And that's how I started, you know, yeah. And that was like 13, 14.
Who are some of the people inspiring you from dancehall?
Bon Tequila, Vibes Cartel, Skilly, you know, very talented.
Interesting, because you didn't mention a woman.
Yeah, I listen to a lot of music, you know?
Yes. So you're not inspired by any of the women, the dancehall divas?
Yes, I really love Spice.
In hip-hop, who are some of the influences?
I listen to, like, a lot of underground artists, you know? Artists that people don't really know. But I would say I like Drake, and I listen to Tory sometimes. I like Party Next Door. Rapper-wise, I like Lil Baby.
Lil Baby?
Yeah.
Okay. So what's next? What's coming?
Chopper Girl mixtape, July 10th.
Yes.
I'm going to have like 8 songs on there.
Mm-hmm.
And that mixtape, everybody's going to get to know everything about me. Everything.
All right.
Like, yeah, lyrically, everything.
Okay.
It's me.
Your range.
My range,
your cross,
my tone,
genre,
my craft, everything.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for coming and sharing with us.
Thank you for having
me. Miss Milan.
I appreciate
it. Honey, is your...
Honey Milan.
What is the real name, though?
Tina Lynch.
Tina Lynch.
Yeah.
All right, Miss Lynch. Thanks for coming and sharing with us. All the very best.
Thank you.
With
so
your
much.
Career, my dear. All right. So there you have her in this segment. Honey Milan on our stage.